Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of What Ted Says, where it's always time to get a fatter wallet and to get a bigger net worth. And today what we're gonna be talking about is what to do when you get an inheritance. Like, this is a tough time. You might have had a mom or a dad or a brother or a sister. Unfortunately, we've seen more than 500,000 deaths in the past year due to COVID. And a lot of people have had to deal with this. So it's a very difficult time to be thinking about what to do with your money. So let's talk about this. You get an inheritance. Maybe it's $100,000, maybe it's $10,000, maybe it's $1 million. What do you do? The first rule in here is do nothing for 60 days. I'm gonna tell you that when money comes into your hands, people come out of the woodwork. Friends that you didn't know you had, relatives who may ask for a handout or money for their business, but a lot of people are gonna come asking you for money. So I highly encourage you for the first 60 days, don't sell the stocks and bonds, don't make any major moves with real estate, don't undo the business that you inherited. Make sure that you take a step back, take a deep breath before you get into the process of thinking what you're gonna do with your money. So the next important move is to understand the tax implications. So first of all, you should know that when you get an inheritance, different assets are taxed in different ways. And if your family owes estate tax, which you have to check into, that's gonna be due 9 months after the date of death. So you have to make sure you have enough liquidity or assets on hand to pay that money. If you got other assets like individual stocks and bonds, you're gonna have to see what your cost basis is. Generally, that means when you inherit, let's say, Apple stock from somebody and they bought it for $10 and now it's worth $100 as the rule stands today, your cost basis is that $100, which means if you sell it tomorrow, there isn't going to be any tax. That's untrue for things like IRA accounts. Now, depending whether you're the spouse or non-spouse, you may have to take those IRA assets and completely take them out of the IRA in 10 years. It will depend if it's a regular IRA or a Roth IRA, and I encourage you, this is the time to seek professional help. Find a high quality fiduciary or financial advisor. Find somebody that you can trust. Go to a website like The Advisor Connect. Find those places where you can find somebody who can help you if you don't understand all the tax implications. The third thing to do here is to pay off debt. Listen, interest rates aside, and people always have this argument, oh, my interest rate is only 3%, or oh, my interest rate is only 1.9%. There is no better feeling, this is spoken personally, and I can tell you this professionally from people I've dealt with for years, than paying off your debt. It's like the bricks off your shoulder. It makes you go to sleep at night. It helps you rest better. It helps you drive in your driveway and say, I own that thing. The bottom line is paying off that debt gives you a completely clean slate. And the worst case scenario is all those things you just paid off, if you had to sell them, you own all of them. So I do recommend things like paying off the house, paying off the cars, getting rid of credit card debt, getting rid of student loan debt, before you think about the 52 other things that you want to do with this inheritance. The fourth thing that you need to do here is to create a cash reserve. Now, I'm gonna play conservative here, and I realize the rules of thumbs may say you only need to have 3 months in a cash reserve, but if you get a nice inheritance, it's really, really smart, and I know you won't make a lot of interest on it, to get 12 months of your monthly expenses in a cash reserve. So if you know you're spending $3,000 a month, take $36,000, set it aside in a savings account and know that it is there for rainy day opportunities or rainy day emergencies. And that's gonna be important. Now that you paid off debt, now that you've got that cash reserve, you've got those two foundations really laid for your house. So now you can build upon it with the regular investments like real estate, like the stock market, or investing in businesses. And the last thing in here is to make sure you get sentimental items valued or appraised. Now, you might inherit some watches. You may inherit a coin collection, you may inherit a piece of art, and you're not really sure, A, what it's worth, and B, whether or not you even wanna keep it. Now, if you wanna keep it, there's no discussion whatsoever. If you wanna sell it, my recommendation is to get it appraised. One, you're gonna wanna put that on your insurance now in case anybody steals it, or there's a flood, or there's damage to your house, or a fire. You know that you've actually got a picture of that item, and you've got an appraisal of that item, so you can actually get paid by the insurance company. But if you're gonna sell it, you wanna make sure you get as much to the fair market value as you can. You're not gonna be able to do that until you get an independent appraisal. The wrong thing to do is to have somebody come by the house, they see all this stuff and they go, oh, what about that painting? You're like, bah, I don't know, just give me $3,000 for it. And it ends up that that painting is worth $30,000. It's a mistake that I see a lot of people make. Listen, I know speaking firsthand in here, when somebody passes away in your family and you inherit something, these are very difficult times. The last thing on your mind mostly is money. But when the dust settles and you've got to figure all this out, you have to have a good guideline to go by. If you use these five tips I gave you today of what to do when you get an inheritance and you follow that list, you'll be much better off with your money down the road. It's what helps you get a fatter wallet and a bigger net worth. Please, if you know anybody that recently had somebody pass away and they're thinking about what to do with an inheritance, have them watch this video. Make sure that you and your friends click the button, subscribe, you click the notifications button, you'll get more information like this that will help you ultimately have that fatter wallet and a bigger net worth. Thanks for watching this episode of What Ted Says.